Hello, this video will be about vascular dementia history taking. The main clinical skill you need to depend on while performing this station is the style of question. I mean, to use open-ended questions whenever possible. The difference between using open-ended questions and using closed-ended questions in collecting information or history taking is the same difference between fishing with using fishnet and with using fish hook. It's so easy. While using a fish hook, that one fish can come so close and so near to the fish hook and go away without being picked up. But on the other hand, if the same fish are present in the area which is contained by fish net, it will be collected and picked up. The same also if you depend on closed-ended questions to assess presence of some symptoms. For example, if you are going to assess presence of behavioral changes. If you assumed that the patient may have specific or certain behavioral changes and start to ask the relative, you might find that the patient is not suffering from assaultiveness to others, being apathetic or detached, being withdrawn, or being aggressive. And you can consider that you cover this area very well because you asked maybe 4 or 5 questions about all these symptoms. And you can transfer to the next topic to check and to collect information regarding it. While the only change in behavior that present with the patient you missed and didn't ask about, he is giving comments of sexual nature, or if he is sexually disinhibited, you can easily lose it. But if you use open-ended questions to elicit behavioral changes with the patient of dementia, and by asking the relative, Mrs. Smith, have you noticed any change in his behavior since he started to experience difficulties with his mood? She will tell you, yes, doctor, he shows embarrassing behaviors of sexual nature. And you can ask her anything else. If there is anything else, she will tell you. If there is nothing, she will tell you no. And here, you can transfer to the next topic. And as you see here, in shorter time, you elicit the positive finding. But with using short-ended questions, you might consume more time with failure of eliciting the positive finding at the end. Because all things that you are expecting or assuming and are asking about are not present. So using open-ended questions in this station is especially important. And while preparing this station, try to start to ask about each domain of symptoms by an open-ended questions. For example, if the patient started to experience memory problems or symptoms of dementia 1 year ago, so you can ask the relative questions like this. Do you have any concerns about his physical health over the last year? And you can ask, how is he at doing activities of daily living? Do you have any worries about his safety at home? Or how do you describe his behaviors over the last year? And you can continue asking about different domains in the history in the same manner. And if the relative gave you history of symptoms, ask about other symptoms if she noticed. And you can also use closed-ended questions just to check presence or absence of a specific symptom you are interested to know about them. While asking about the patient's performance, some candidates are mistaken when they are asking the relative, is he still able to look after himself and to do activities of daily living? And if the patient replied, yes, he is still able to do that, those candidates transfer to the next point without checking. If the patient is consuming more time than usual, or if he is still able to do those activities of daily living with more trials than his usual. So it's very important if you are going to assess his ability to finish tasks is to ask, is he still able to do daily life tasks? And if he is still able, you need to ask, but does he take longer time to finish those tasks? Because slowness and difficulties in performing tasks are one of the symptoms of early dementia. One important thing here to be mentioned, while assessing risks, it's better to divide them in 3 groups. The first group is to ask the patient, do you have any worries about his safety at home? And here, if there is anything dangerous to him, or if there is any risky behaviors, she will tell you about. And you can ask her closed-ended questions about specific risks to complete your assessment. And then to ask her, what about outdoors? Are you worried about him if he went out? She will tell you about things like wandering, losing his way to home, difficulties in crossing roads or driving, and all these things. And the third group of risks you have to ask about the risks from others. I mean, those elderly patients are vulnerable to be exploited financially and to be abused physically and even sexually sometimes. So you need to ask her if there is any risks from others toward the patient just to complete the assessment. And by depending on open-ended questions, you can finish collecting all important informations and all positive findings in very short period of time. And you can find time to ask about care stress and also to acknowledge and to appreciate efforts the wife is doing to help her husband, like what happened with me when the cessation came to me in the exam. In the last minute, there was plenty of time to mention something about her support to her husband. I told her, it's clear to me that you are looking after him very well. You are reminding him to receive his medications and you are supporting him in daily life. And this is great to know that he is receiving a care like this from someone caring and loving like you. She smiled at me and told me, he used to be nice to me all the time and he is a great man and he deserves even more than what I'm doing for him. And I asked her, but do you find any difficulties looking after him? Or is this exhausting to you? She told me, no, doctor, I'm happy to look after him. I told her, that's great to know that you are not suffering because of caring of him. And the station ended at that point. And I told her, thank you for being open with me. And from what you have told me, it's clear that your husband is suffering from what is called vascular dementia. I mean, problem in his memory and functions of his brain because of shortage of blood supply to his brain cells. And this is a manageable condition. And in another session, we can tell you in details how we are going to help him and you to deal with his illness. I hope these tips are helpful to all of you. And thank you.